Greetings of the day, and welcome to Prof. Neil once again. Today we are going to discuss about how to be a mirror or a candle. I take my personal example in this, and when I was appointed as a teacher at the Institute of Hotel Management, Pusa, New Delhi, in 1989, I was just 24 years old, and I was a South Indian from born and brought up in the town of Ahmedabad, a very small town then, Gujarat. I was not only overawed by the grandeur of the capital city of India, New Delhi, but also overawed by the campus of Pusa, a 1-acre campus with a verdant landscape and the infrastructure. In comparison to my alma mater then, IHM Ahmedabad, Pusa was like Mukesh Ambani's Antilla building, and my alma mater was maybe like a one studio bedroom apartment in Bombay, that kind of place, not even that kind of space. So imagine my state. I was overawed, totally overawed. And then when I saw my students for the first time in my life, I realized that I had a challenge on my hands. We were raw when we were in first year 1983. We didn't know what real management was all about. These students know. They were articulate, intelligent, diligent, well, excellently groomed. And I mean, you name them, they're exceptional. I was very blessed to have them in my life. They had all passed their national joint entrance examination with good marks, and then also carried those marks into the interviews. The interviews are tough, grueling, I tell you. There are four principals of the Institute of Hotel Management who grill these students. And finally, you get to choose the top colleges. In those days, top colleges were Bombay and Delhi. And those who got Delhi were the top of the list. So here were them. And I had to inspire them as my teacher. As their teacher, I had to inspire them. My responsibility. That's when I remembered that quote which I had read about long back. There are two ways of spreading light. To be the candle or to be the mirror that reflects it. Their pedigree was exceptional. The majority of my cricket team boys were, which I coach and manage. A gully cricketer. They're all under 19, under 17, under 18, under 19 players who had represented the state. What cricket could teach them? I learned from them. My writers club team, I was a faculty advisor. Ajay Punj, the master of the written word. The Times of India editorials were substandard. She could have written better editorials. Mehrangiz Bharucha, my creative head. She need not have got, there's no need for her to be to go to NID. She was born with creative genes. Such was her creativity. Nirbhik Goel, my student editor. Leadership, perfect. He managed the team so well. Plus his knack of choosing these people like Mehrangiz, Ajay, Kabir Khattar, all these people, Mohan Mathur. And to bring them, I didn't know all of them at all. He noticed these little traits in them, and he was also excellent. He was also an excellent writer in Hindi, which we needed. So that is it. So I chose to become a mirror and reflect their light to themselves. I couldn't overshadow them. I didn't have that caliber. Coming to classrooms, for which I was primarily assigned to. Any fool could teach them these subjects of front office, bookkeeping, etc. But imagine my state. Imagine how blessed I was when one of your students is a National Bravery Award winner who's been honored during the Republic Day parade by the President of India. A Commonwealth, the winner of a Commonwealth country's short story competition. I could go on and on about each one of them. Each one of them had a trait in them which brought them there. I was scared because they obeyed every word of mine as their command. I thought how to go about it, and I had to inspire them. It was my responsibility. I knew I could not be their son and black out those candles, those exquisite, lovely candles whose light was so beautiful. So I chose to be a mirror of the great teachers who influenced me, and reflected their light back on them. And forgetting the subject, I chose, like my teachers, to focus on character, discipline, and other important aspects for life, and also for the hotel industry, which is a very demanding industry. A teacher is known by students and not vice versa. Today my students credit me for the success, but the credit is there solely and only because I believe and practice like my teachers. When a student is successful, it is his or her success. But when a student fails, it is the teacher's failure. But here I am selfish a little bit. I attribute my success to my teachers, but my students' success is theirs only. For their failure, I am responsible. And thanks to that thought, I have an extended family of almost 1,000 members in my group, for whom I could kill and who would die for me, whom I love and care and respect. That's one view of inspiring, which I learned by my own self. Be the mirror. If you can't be the candle, be the mirror to reflect the light. Thank you. See you next time. Bye-bye.